Colin and I flew to Loreto 5 months after I had left Ravenswing in the Puerto Escondido harbor. The airplane flew right over the boat. I was pretty anxious to see what we would find. She was in great shape, except for the bird poop that had covered the boat. 5 months crusted on, it was pretty gross. So we got to work, took 2 days of scrubbing, and doing some repair work. First up was fixing the main sheet bases that didn't have enough reinforcement on the hull. You can see the cracks on the inside. Everything got stripped back. Laminations were added. Repairs made. The weather was warm and beautiful, so I was able to work through the night as needed. Epoxy kicked off quickly, so we got a lot done very fast. After cleaning everything up, also had to go up the mast and rig up some improvements to the lazy jacks, and finally she was ready to go. We settled up the bill with the marina, thanked the guys who had watched the boat during those 5 months, and pulled on out of Puerto Escondido, southbound. Day one underway, Colin and Greg sailing Ravenswing from Puerto Escondido at Loreto, Baja, all the way back to San Francisco. We're leaving on Sunday, September 13 is today. We had 2 days of boat work in Escondido, including massive, copious amounts of bird guano. It's hideous. It's like glue. But a short run today to Agua Verde, 22 miles down. And this is what we're trying to figure out where to anchor, probably right over in here. Ravenswing's cleaned up. She's ready for the sea. Well, actually, the captain was a little rusty, forgot the windlass circuit breaker, a little bit of a fire drill, and so we pulled out to sea and decided to keep going. Caught a beautiful mahi and fish tacos and a beautiful evening sail, Colin's first overnighter towards Espiritu Santo. Okay, good people, paddling in paradise. Look at this turquoise water anchorage at Isla Partida. This is Isla Espiritu Santo over here on the left. We're in the little passage in between. It's not navigable except for pangas and dinghies over there. Colin's on his board, way out in the distance, off the bow, and I'll get on mine. We left Puerto Escondido yesterday, sailed about 115 miles. Light wind, motor sailing down here, and we'll go to LaPaz tomorrow morning. Just taking a lay day here on the island. And one day of exploring the turquoise water should be good. Let's take a look at the good ship Ravenswing in full cruiser mode. Sunshades. Okay, that's a pretty big cove to paddle across. Oh, nice fish over here. Oh, you're out of the wind. Good call.
I saw a bunch of rays coming over.
Oh, really? Nice. That's better than getting out of a taxi. Conch shells? Really? Here, can I go where you are? It's more fragile than the rubber ones. Man, you could just about have a driftwood bonfire, huh? Nice spot. Cactus going right to the sea. Doesn't get old. So if we feel like going back into the wind, we can go around the corner and up through, check out the Partita Pass. Is it a coral or a lava? Yeah, it feels like lava up on this. Wouldn't you want to just stay here for a month? And we're just, what, 20 miles from a big city? Supplies? No wonder that everybody loves this place. Jeannie, this feels like same temperature as the swim spa. Except it's got sand and fish. Okay, Colin's got a good idea. Sit on top paddle boards. Never tried it like this. Big gust. Trying to stay out of the wind. This works pretty good too. These are the pelicans related to the ones in Puerto Escondido that crapped all over Ravenswing and gave us 2 days of work cleaning off their poop. Satan's birds. Oh. And ho! Soft. Oh, it's a bit of a walk over to the outside of the islands. It is a total honor and a treat to do this trip with our firstborn son. Thanks, Colin, for making the time from work. It's a good day to rest up because we got a long upwind journey starting in just a couple of days. We can enjoy our way out of the Sea of Cortez and onto the Pacific coast. Crossing the pass here to step onto Espiritu Santo for a few minutes. That way we can be on two islands on the same day. Tricky landing with paddleboards, so this may not be my best idea. Ah, we get to go downwind. Shallow pass between the islands. It's low tide, so it's maybe 3 or 4 feet deep. I want to land over here and check out the camp. Oh, there's a good little spot. Shoes would have been a good idea. Oh well. Oh honey, you want to come and pick shells here? Ooh. I'd never get you out of this place. National Park. And yes, we have our park visit permit. Turns out it's supposed to be a wristband that I'm wearing, but it's on the boat anyway. I don't see any rangers coming to us anytime soon though. Nice fishing net chair. It's Ravenswing, the one on the right. Okay, people, here's a first diving on one's own anchor in a nice remote tropical looking place. So we've got a chain. Keep it off the boat with the spinnaker tack. And here's the bridle line. We only bridle one side. That way we can leave the bobs stay all intact. And we're in like only 10 feet of water. And I think it's right down there. Let's go get it. Harbor, Marina Cortez, and Colin found some dings on the daggerboard that we want to clean up, so we bought some Splash Zone underwater curing epoxy, and he has prepped the board. I've just made him a little kind of a wad, size of a bigger than a golf ball. Let's go see if we can track what he's up to. He's down there. In December, we'll be unstepping the mast, which means we can get the daggerboard up on deck, and we'll sand all this stuff back and do proper repair and add a little Kevlar layer to the bottom 6 inches or so of the board. Got that all cleaned up for you guys. Okay, we had our little Tohatsu 9.8 powerhouse motor sitting in the hole for the 5 months. Got a little corrosion. I wasn't able to rinse it in fresh when we left. So when we fired it up, it was not spitting water. So Colin has just done a masterful, pipe cleaner. Okay. We're gonna keep pipe cleaning this thing, hopefully get her running nice and smooth. Yeah, we're just getting old salt junk out. Cortez in LaPaz. You can buy the upper floor condos. They want $1 million a piece, but I bet it's negotiable. That's peeing nicely now. Well, it was this delicious lunch in LaPaz that caused the aha moment you're about to see next.
Okay, it's Thursday evening in LaPaz. There's the Malecón of LaPaz. And Ravenswing is decked out for cruising. We've We've made all adjustments and repairs we wanted. Got new jerry cans of gas. But we've made a massive decision. We are not gonna go to Cabo. We're gonna turn around and go north. You guys will have figured it out by now by the time you see this video, watching the tracker and all that. But we realize we wanna keep the boat in the Sea of Cortez for a full season, probably a full year. And I've contacted Puerto Peñasco. They've got room. So that's the place I want to take the boat, and I'm going to haul her out. We're going to do some upgrades. Going to change out our windows. She needs bottom paint. Some detail work. Mostly cosmetic stuff. And then we'll enjoy the Northern Sea. We can get there by car from home easily. It's COVID safe. We can stay socially distant at that place. And the more we've read about the North Sea of Cortez, the more magical it sounds and good to our style. So tomorrow we will head out to where apparently you can swim with seal pups at Isleta, north of Isla Partida, and then make our way up to Conception Bay. We've got 13 days till we need to be in Puerto Peñasco, so it should be a nice 450-mile cruise. Getting excited! And relieved we're not going to be bashing home this year. This is Los Islotes on the northern tip of Isla Partida, a little separate island where there's it's a seal rookery. So we're looking for seals. We're actually not going to stop and get in the water. You can't anchor here. Of course, this boat looks like it's anchored. And we're not set up to go back to the island and anchor and dinghy over. We're going to keep rolling. So we're just going to have a good look. Are those seals over there? To the right of the mooring ball? Damien said he came out here and actually was swimming with a seal pup. We're in 65 feet of water. It's Partida. Cool how it shapes down to the sea. We spent the night at Ensenada Grande around the corner. That is crazy. The second anchorage in Grande has water that literally looks like a swimming pool. I've never seen that kind of aquamarine. We went to the third one, which had incredible snorkeling along these cliffs. Saw all kinds of fish, coral just off the cliff. It's great. And then we're wide open to the Sea of Cortez. We're gonna make a 185-mile run up to Conception Bay. It's a bit of a tailwind. Hopefully that'll be less than 24 hours. Yeah, probably pretty good snorkeling here. Have to come back to this place. Think you can start turning left. There we go. Spanga's dropping off all their snorkelers on the calm side. Definitely have to come back here. It's great when it wasn't so windy. Okay, it's day one of the first real sailing from La Paz up to Puerto Peñasco. So we left LaPaz down here with all the little X's are. And we're headed 480 miles up to Puerto Peñasco, which is at the top of the Sea of Cortez. And after we take the boat out there, it will be a 60-mile drive into Arizona. So Ravenswing will be up here. So we'll hold out of the water so we can do some maintenance and upgrade work. So we have just passed Isla San Jose. And we're headed up, basically staying a few miles, up to 10 miles off the Baja coast. That's our plan. We're just meandering through these islands. This is where I stopped on the way north, Isla Montserrat. Isla Carmen is there. And there's Puerto Puerto Escondido, where the boat spent the 5 months during quarantine. We're going to bypass all of that and go on up to Conception Bay. It's our first leg destination, about 150 miles. It's light wind, downwind sailing. Getting about 7 knots out of the current conditions. Reacher's pulling as best it can. Got a little makeshift charging setup to see if we can get this little starter battery going again for the outboard. Lost its juice during the quarantine wait. This is the best place to sleep. It's cooler air in the shade. US number 5 pulling her weight. We're looking for wildlife.
Being in the middle of September, we found some of the nights just too hot to sleep inside the cabin. So yeah, Kai, you're right. Taco made a great sea bunk.
Smooth boat making her way through the light blue sea. September 20th, 9:40 in the morning. It's been a lot of motoring these first 24 hours. Going through some gas, keeping it light. 3,700 on the RPMs gives us... Oops, we're going slow. Only 5 knots of boat speed. I got distracted because I'm making pancakes and eggs. Coffee. The mate up there deserves a little treat for breakfast since get the 4 a.m. shift. He's sleeping up front there. That's Conception Point. We're going to bypass Conception Bay because it's big. You don't really want to spend all the time going in there. So we're headed for an island just north of it where there's supposed to be some good snorkeling. Along a reef, but mellow morning, not much going on out here. Saw one ship an hour or so ago, and that's it. No pleasure boat traffic, and no wind. The telltales are only moving because we're doing that.
Oh well.
Passing the point at the head of Conception Bay. The bay goes in around this corner, like 20 miles down. It's pretty mellow over there. And we're looking for Isla San Marcos, which I think is right off the bow of the dinghy out there. And 24 miles away. We'll make that a stop. Just got going sailing an hour ago. After like 20 hours of motoring. It's a nice little breeze, 8 to 10 knots I'd say. Yeah. Start a little white caps, might be 8 to 12, or 10 to 12. Okay, we're trying to get to an anchorage straight ahead. There's one boat there. A half a mile on this very remote looking Isla San Marcos. Just spent a while negotiating getting around the light out there. Adverse winds. It set sail a mile off of it. There's a reef out there, which thankfully we did not find. Dramatic looking place. More and more upwind. Don't have a head sail up. Gonna have to drop the main and motor on in here. Santa Rosalia is 11 miles that way somewhere. We'll go over there tomorrow. We should see the city lights tonight. Hopefully we'll have a mellow night here. Do a little swimming. We're both hot and bothered. We did get some nice sailing in finally today. The boat was up to 10 knots in downwind sailing. So I took it off autopilot and hand steered for about 3 hours. And you have to drive the boat. It's been a long time.
Indeed, we had a beautiful couple of nights on San Marcos. Great snorkeling. We'll show you that next time and make our way up to Bahia de Los Angeles. Thanks for watching.